Hi everyone, welcome back to now I kind of wish I would have brought my bombs and crap with me. Oh, that leads straight down to a mushroom biome. Down there seems like it'd be a climb up. There we go. And right here kind of seems like it'd be a good spot. I mean, lava itself on this game does not travel very far, at least not very fast anyway. So one thing I'm gonna start doing is I'm gonna start recording. Like, next time that me and, oh no! Let that drain out, and down there. Yeah, doesn't look like that's gonna interfere, so. Crap, that chamber wasn't big enough. If I had that one, what is it, I forget what the name of it. It's a, an accessory that makes you immune to lava for 7 seconds, I believe. That's not going to be enough. Mostly what I want is particularly when it comes to the whole streaming aspect, I want that person that like pushes me, that like, you know, keeps saying, oh, you can do it, you know, keep going, keep trying, you know, I want someone like that in my life. You know, I can't rely on anybody else to do that for me, so. I guess I've just reached the point where I'm tired of being stuck. That's gonna be in the way. Die, skeleton. Yep, this side over here is gonna be in the way. This comes down here. Actually, may not be in the way. Not this time. much as I want to grab those, I'm not going to. Okay, what the? It does it sometimes. It gets it to where I can't place rope down. I don't get why it does that sometimes. I mean, I see ads, I see, you know, like, people that... that have, like, such passion when they do things, that they, you know, have such a drive to do things. And, frankly, it's... I don't know how to do that. I'm so used to being reserved, so used to... people treating me like crap, to a degree anyway, that I guess the best way to put it, I just feel inadequate. And I don't know how to get out of that mindset. I'm gonna have to get more rope. I guess the main thing is, I want to be noticed by someone, you know, and I actually want to feel like I have a purpose. And just, I don't know. Because I don't feel as though I have a purpose, I just feel as though I simply just live day to day, like, caught in the same cycle. Matrix effect, if you will. Mind you, me and my emotions don't talk, at least not very often. And if any of you are familiar with this, the native story, The Tale of the Two Wolves, it's an Indian-based story. For those that are not familiar with it, it's basically the grandpa was talking to his grandson, and then as they were talking, the subject of him feeling angry, I believe that's how it goes, and he talked to his grandfather, and he's like, I don't understand why I feel so angry all the time. He's like, all of us have two wolves inside of us. One is all the good aspects of ourselves, the other is all the negative aspects of ourselves. He goes into a bit more detail, but... and after they talk a bit more regarding the wolf and whatnot, grandson looks at his grandfather and is like, well, which wolf wins? And he simply goes into a thoughtful moment, looks at his son, smiles, and says, it's the one you feed. Now, the reason why I bring that up is because I've been feeding the negative aspect of myself, I guess, a little too much, a little too long. Because I see the white wolf in the distance, with its back turned to me. But I see the black wolf going into a frenzy and a rage because I've been giving him too much attention. And after talking with someone who has come a friend to me, named Jay, or Jaylin to be exact, said he'd always be there for me. If I need to talk, vent, whatever the case. And he's like a little brother to me. But I'm so afraid of being close to someone. That I don't know how to build bonds. At least not lasting ones. Because growing up, my parents failed me. Like, miserably failed me. My dad, talking with him, he's openly admitted to me that he messed up. As a father, he wasn't ready to be a father. And looking back on it, I agree with him on that. But despite that, he's still the only family that messages me. Would occasionally come over before he moved over to Ohio. And before he left, he told me if I need anything, just to shoot him a text or call him. He'll respond when he can. He does the best he can with what he knows and has. But because he's a drunk, he's not like a mean drunk or anything like that. But because he's a drunk, his sister has completely disowned him and abandoned him. And I see differently. I see that he's trying. That's not something that my sister sees. All she sees is that he's a drunk and that he even gives up the alcohol or he's not going to be a part of her life. And he's like, you can't do that to someone. Whether you're mad at him or not, you can't give him an ultimatum like, you must do this, otherwise, forget ever being in my life. You can't do that to someone, particularly someone that's a drunk, and that he's trying. But she doesn't see it as that. She just, I'm not exactly fully sure how she sees it. No, you don't, Mother Slime. Go away. And anybody that's ever dealt with an alcoholic in the family, you can't just abandon them. Because generally, they are the ones that need the most help. And if you abandon them, regardless if you like, hate them, whatever the case, abandoning someone just because they're drunk, that's a really poor reason to abandon. But I understand my sister's side of it as well. as she herself has had a drinking problem in the past. Through her husband, she was able to get past that, at least I think it got past it. I personally don't like him. Not because he's married to her, but because he's a bit egotistical. Me and him are like oil and water. We do not mix. Now, mind you, I haven't talked to my sister about any of this stuff, because I don't feel it's going to do anything, but eventually I'm going to leave Colorado. I'm probably going to be leaving Colorado soon. I'm going to be going on a journey. I don't know where it's going to take me. I don't know where I'm going to end up. I'm just going to pick a direction I'm going to go. And I'm going to be doing that. Most likely this summer, early spring summer. Though some people have tried telling me, it's like, well, why don't you take, like, do small, like a small journey? It's like, I can't do that. It's not, you just simply go out to the park next door and then just stay there for an hour and then go back. That's not what it is. I have no idea what the journey is going to take me, as I said. I don't know where the end destination is. That's part of the adventure. It's not the end goal that matters. It's the journey along that matters. Now, a lot of people, like when I was still talking with my mom at one point, she was very hesitant about me doing that. But the point of the journey is to find myself. Finding yourself type of journey. You're finding your real self. Now, I could easily be killed on that journey. Honestly, I'm fine with that. Death doesn't frighten me like it does a lot of people. I embrace it should it happen. However, I refuse to be killed in a cowardly manner. Now, if any of this is a depressing matter for you, I apologize right now. That's just my viewpoint on it. Sorry if any of this ever hit a dark, if any of this is hit a dark point to you. I apologize now, but I'm just putting my viewpoint out there on that. Now, if any of you, like, want to, like, say, whisper me or talk with me directly or whatnot, I do not have my Twitch settings blocked for anybody that wants to whisper me. So if any of you ever want to talk with me, message me, whatever the case. They are open. Oh, wait. That was background noise. on that noise. Background wall. I was distracted again. And I'm not gonna be making this journey by by driving. I'm gonna be making this journey by walking. The old traditional way of going about it. What are you trying to show me, Fury? Trying to show me a chest? A heartstone? I see it. Unlike you, fairy, that can float through walls, I can't. I have to gradually go that way. I'm on my way, fairy. I'm on my way. Alright, what are you trying to show me, fairy? Oh, it's a chest. Okay. Well, thank you for showing me a chest. Sorry, this episode just got a bit depressing, didn't it? I apologize. I will take that, and I'll take the geyser too. Oh, campfire, cool. Alright, this one I'm gonna put one of those doors. to go back up and find more rope, I guess. Or find that one accessory that allows me to collect, vine, and then I can create that into a type of rope. Huh. I forget I can do that. Huh. A renewable rope. I'm gonna have to go back up soon. I knew it was like... There we go. Not knocking me in there. Ooh, I can look like a unicorn. Screw you, worm. Worms? I said screw off. Well, I'm officially out of worms. I'm almost there though. Oh wait. I want to knock that out. Yeah, it's gonna go straight into this lava pit. I haven't said much in the past couple minutes. Kind of concentrating at the moment. don't feel like going into the lava. Come here, babies. I just feel like I'm like Markiplier that one where they're talking about like punching babies and whatnot. It's not a slight towards anyone either, so I don't ever want anyone to feel that it is. I think I technically picked up a spelunking potion, but... I'm going to go, technically go back and think I was either silver or platinum I found back there. Wait, I didn't just... Okay, whatever. I'm gonna have to go back soon. Oh no! Are you freaking... plenty of those. Oh, cool. I have the most of you, so... I don't have any summons. Oh, wait. Give me one sec, everyone. Be back with part 10.